You know, there's various ways of moving in the things of God. By that, I mean everyone who's born again has the power of God, has the Spirit of God. What I'm doing today is I'm going to minister on certain principles of the kingdom of God. Remember, the principles of the kingdom are the keys to the kingdom. Amen. And now, and you know, the enemy, many times he uses the various, the different things that we do in church, denominations, to put a wedge between the body. But that should not be. Amen. Because, I mean, some of you saw signs and wonders and God do great things without using these principles or without being cognizant that you were using them. And so all God's people have power.
Amen.
You know, if you got a Bible and you got a prayer life, you can get just about anything in the kingdom of God. We're just tweaking things a little bit so you'll know how to push your faith even further and how to have a greater understanding of what you're doing. Amen? And so we said that point number one, and I might go through this and I might not, but you can look up these verses during the week. Give you a little extra homework. But we said faith starts in the heart pertaining to the New Testament believer. When, if you're born again, faith starts in the heart. Now, it says in 1 Peter 3:4, but let it be the hidden man of the heart in that which is not corruptible. So, I know that he's talking about the women in the church at that time, but my point here is that there's a man on the inside of you, a spirit man. He don't have a heart, none of that. It's a spirit man. Behavior science talks about the subconscious. They know somebody's down there. Who's in there? But the word of God, which is the book of books, says it's a hidden man of the heart. There's a man on the inside of you. The real you is the spirit man. You have a soul and you live in a body. But faith starts with the word of God bearing witness with the inner man. 2 Corinthians 4:16, for which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. And so we understand faith, the word of God has to get into the inner man. Now, the beauty of this is that once the word of God gets in the inner man, once the word of God talks about the entrance of God's word brings light. And once the light of what you're believing God for gets into that inner man, nothing can stop manifestation. Because that's where faith begins. If you can get the word of God past your cerebral forces, and you know, don't argue with it. Even if you can't understand it, just receive it.
Amen.
Proverbs 3:5. Just trust the Lord with all your heart. Now we're not talking about being stupid. You know, we're not talking about being foolish. You know, we're just talking about whatever you're believing God for today.
Yes.
Saturate your heart. You know, bombard your heart with the word of God until it gets in there. Someone has said, until it gets in your knower. And you'll know it in your knower. Stay with that word until you know it in your knower. Everything in your knower has let you know that you have the petition that you've asked God for. Now remember this, you always have it before you have it. It's kind of like it's not a mystery, but your faith will let you know. The inward man of the heart will let you know you've made contact with the promise of God, and it's just a matter of time now. It's just a matter of time that everyone will see the reality of your faith. Amen. You've engaged the word of God. Amen. You've saturated your inner man with the word of God, and you're going to testify. Amen. The one who has seen you in secret.
Yes.
Amen. The Almighty who has seen your fellowship with him in his word in secret is going to reward you openly. Somebody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now, Romans 10:10. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So we understand that there is a need for the inward man to engage the word of God. Now, this will save your life. This will bring financial increase to you in spite of your education that you might have or might not have. See, because the truth is always greater than the fact.
Yes.
You know, it's a fact that maybe you just got your high school diploma, but the truth is you have the mind of Christ. It's a fact. Maybe you got a BA degree, you know, your bachelor. Maybe you got a master's. Maybe you got a doctorate. But remember, they're only degrees. It's a degree, right? Are you the one say, I'm not trying to be controversial. But I'm just saying, it's just a degree. You know? So if you had 10 of them, it's just like you still need the wisdom of God. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. You need the wisdom of God. Amen. And the word of God is clear. We have the mind of Christ.
All right.
And so when the promise of God, and you know, the word is seed. You know, the word is seed. And you know, when you believe in God, you should always name your seed. And you should always sow something in light of that seed. You know, you believe in God for a house. You know, we have these, I don't have one up here today. What's the envelopes? You know, when you're offering, you know, you should always name your seed. Thank you for my new house. Thank you for my promotion on my job. Amen. For with God, nothing is impossible and nothing is incurable. And strong faith will push past your cerebral forces that say now there's a limit.
Yeah.
And now you're not going to own no company. You know good and well. You know, y'all coming out of the projects. Dad didn't work. You know, mom was always struggling. You talk about you going to get a company. See, you got to push past that.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you are a CEO. God does have more for you. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. It hasn't even entered into the hearts of those, amen, who love God.
Yes.
Amen. But he does reveal those things to us by his spirit. So God has something for you today that you're not full. You haven't engaged in that thing yet. But if you stay in the word, the spirit of God will take the word of God and bring to your heart.
Yeah,
that inner man will perceive there's more for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That inner man will begin to bear witness that there is an inheritance that I have now in the earth, and I must seize it. I must begin to seize my opportunity in the earth, because it is the will of God for me to be blessed in the earth as it is in heaven. No sickness in heaven, no sickness in you. Amen. No poverty in heaven, no poverty in you. Only joy unspeakable in heaven, only joy unspeakable in you. Amen. Increase, the streets of the city are pure gold. Amen. Amen. And he has given you the silver and the gold. He don't have the eye. He said, remember this. He said, in this last day, I'm going to shake all the nations. And I'm going to shake the desire of all the nations. And then he says, the silver and the gold is mine. All nations want silver and gold. You know what I mean? And all these wars and rumors of war, and most of them are about a hostile takeover. Greed and covetousness. One country wants what another country has. But God says, the silver and the gold is mine. And then he tells Haggai, let my people know that the glory of the latter house, that's our house, is going to be greater than the glory of the former house. And in this house, there's going to be peace. The shalom of God. Nothing missing and nothing broken. God has a great payday for you, but it starts in the spirit. He has a great reward for you. Amen. But it starts in the spirit. Amen. God has a rag to riches story for you if you let him take you there. But it's not by might. It's not by power. It's by the spirit of the living God. Your heart must engage the word of God. And as the inward man begins to get saturated with the incorruptible, indestructible, ever-living, everlasting seed word of Almighty God, those seeds of greatness are going to grow up in you. Amen. And you're going to begin to walk in the inheritance that God has given you in the earth. All the people of God that went home to be with the Lord, never experiencing what God had for them. They traveled down here broke and afflicted and tormented, not knowing there were kings and priests under God. Yeah.
Yep. Glory.
There's more for you, but it starts in the word of God. Yeah. There's more for you, but you're going to have to be a student of the word of God. Study to show yourself approved. Yeah. Being workmen, we work the word. We go after the word like the heathen goes after money, and they will kill you for their money. And I'm just talking about little low-life drug dealers. I'm talking about CEOs, white-collar crime. Which will make the little street crime look like nothing what they do. They'll bring out something they know gonna kill you and let it be out. They tell you 20 years later, oh, we found out this was a, there's a flaw, been a flaw. Y'all made it with a flaw.
Right.
Greedy. And the word of God says that there's going to come a day where the businesses and those who participate in cheating the people and not giving them their due. Yes. It said they're going to want to try to get that wicked money off them. But they're not going to be able to. All that. The Bible talks about how they cheated the people. And the people were so needy they didn't even fight back. They took that little paycheck and went home and did whatever they could. Because they didn't see a way of being able to overcome that evil. So they just took it. But God says that he was going to repay that evil. And when he repays it, it's going to be a screeching in the land. That's found in James chapter 5. James chapter 5. I just want to show you that scripture real quickly. James chapter 5. I guess I won't show you that scripture. James chapter 5, beginning with verse 1, you can read it. Amen. And it talks about how the God is going to deal with the business owners that committed fraud in behalf of the people. You know, and there was more than enough, but it wasn't distributed properly. So getting back to our outline, the inward man, he needs maintenance just like the outer man. And like some of you like me, you say we got to start walking. Got to get in that gym. Why? You know, that's too much. Got to work this thing off, you know. So you go to the gym and get on that treadmill, you know. Start, you know, lifting a little weights. Why? Because you can tell that the outer man is out of shape. Well, the inward man has to be in shape to receive the promises of God. Because the promises of God are not ascertained without a fight. And if you're not in shape, you might not pass the test of what's going on your job. Many times God's trying to promote us, and the devil's trying to use someone to take advantage of us or to get us all upset. Because he knows the wrath of man does not work the righteousness of God. If you have an anger problem, that's just the devil working on your blessing. If you find yourself always angry, you're going to have to get words of peace. Amen? And one of the ways to have peace in your life is to comprehend you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. And it's a gift. It's a gift. You're not righteous by what you do. You're righteous because God made you that way when you got born again. Amen. You act righteous because you are righteous. But even when you're not acting righteous, if you are righteous, that's the gift God gave you so the devil couldn't talk you out of your salvation. You are righteous by the blood of Jesus. He who knew no sin became sin for us, that we might be forever made the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. When the devil tells you, look at you, you done did it again, you done messed up again, you tell him, look at you. You can't have no redemption because you had no temptation. You messed up in a perfect place. Get behind me, Satan. Yes. Get behind me, Satan. Yes. How are you gonna even try to bring condemnation on me when you can't have none of this redemption? Right. You had it all. Yeah. Right. You were the anointed cherubim that covered the throne of God. You saw it all, but you had to get lifted up. Yes. And Isaiah said, I saw Lucifer like a meteorite. I saw him like a fallen star coming through space to the earth, never to ascend again. Amen. Matthew 4:4. Jesus is being tempted. He's on a 40-day fast. He's hungry. And Satan says to him, and now why don't you turn these stones into bread if you be the Son of God? Yeah. He said, look, I know I'm the Son of God, but men don't live by bread alone. He's giving us a tip here. Men don't live by bread alone. Yeah. Amen. Now, I know it's getting till near lunchtime, but, you know, we don't live by chicken and mashed potatoes and short ribs and spare ribs. I better stop it because I'm getting hungry. But we don't live by bread alone. But we live by the words of Almighty God. Amen. That inner man eats the word. That inner man takes in the word and it makes him wise unto salvation. Amen. Psalms 19, beginning with verse 7, says, "The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgments of the Lord, they're true and righteous altogether. More to be desired than gold." God said, you should be in my word. My word is more important than your money. But you talking about Jesus. I need my money. Yeah, you need your money, but the word will show you where the money is and a whole lot of it. And you can work and work and work and work. And you know what? When that company sees that, you know, that you don't fit the image anymore.
Yep.
They'll tell you hit the road. Hit the road, Jack. You ain't coming back. Now they might have to write out a severance for you, but you ain't coming back. They don't want you no more. But the more words you take in and the more wisdom begins to enlighten you, the word of God says over there in Proverbs 4:18 that the path of the justified gets brighter and brighter until the perfect day. Glory to God. It says, with long life, you'll be satisfied as you see the salvation of your God. Amen. You know, which is more than just heaven. Amen. That salvation has started right now. Amen. That salvation, that eternal life is in you right now. And as you fellowship with that eternal life in the word of God, your spirit gets stronger. And now you know how to engage the spirit world. Amen. You learn how to walk in faith and not by sight. You learn the wisdom of the trade. And one of the nuggets of the kingdom of God is learning how to call the thing that be not as though it's already happened. Instead of getting devastated by what you see, you learn how to call what you desire and ignore what you see. That's a major step in the kingdom of God. That's a major step in faith. When you see sickness and say it's well. When you see lack and you say increase. Amen. When you see division and you say reconciliation. Oh, when you learn the wisdom of the kingdom and you learn how to not walk by sight but walk by faith. Now the table's going to turn. I'm increasing. Glory to God. This time last year, I was walking. But I got a new car. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the Holy Ghost will put me in a new place. Hallelujah. Well, as soon as you see faces drop, you know who your friends are.
Keep it real.
Shannon on that. You know who your friends are. You know who the spirit is. Because the friend loves at all times. You say, go ahead, girl. Go on, show me the way, girl. Do that thing. I'm right behind you. I'm on your coattail. But when they like you, he thinks she all that. I know everybody here does. He won't. See, when people start talking that and start articulating that kind of thing, you know where they are. But the Bible says, fret not because of evildoers. Don't be envious against the workers of iniquity. They'll soon be cut down like the grass and wither like the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. You'll dwell in the land. Verily you'll be fed. Delight yourself in the Lord. Go on, go on, go on, go on. Delight yourself in the Lord. Go on, go on, go on. Delight yourself in the Lord. And you'll end up with the desires of your heart. Commit your way unto the Lord and he'll bring it all to pass. He'll bring you right. the apex of his affection.
Yes. Right.
God loves you, God loves you, God loves you, God loves you in a very special way.
Yes.
You know? He's given us all different fingerprints. You know? He knows very hairs on our head. You are so special to God. And when your inner man begins to engage the word of God, you begin to take on new understanding of the kingdom of God and the love of God. Psalms 119, 105, the word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my pathway. Psalms 18, verse 30, as for God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is tried. He is a buckler to all those who put their trust in him. 2 Peter 1:20-21, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation, for the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. We're talking about letting the inward man, the hidden man of the heart, the real you, feast on the word of God. Psalm 138:2, I will worship towards thy holy temple and praise thy name for thy loving kindness and for thy truth, for thou hast magnified thy word above all thy name. Thou hast magnified thy word. Amen. There's something about the word of God. Amen. The Father has magnified the word. Amen. You can't get in the word without increase coming. You can't get in the word without wisdom coming. You can't get in the word without a healing coming. You can't get in the word without a breakthrough coming. You can't get in the word and not bring forth fruit. It's impossible, because he has magnified his word above all his name. God loves his word.
Amen.
God loves his son Jesus. He so loved the world that he gave his prized possession, that whosoever would believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life and everything that comes with that life.
Yes. Amen.
Ezra 7:10. For Ezra had prepared his heart to seek the law of the Lord and to do it, and to teach in Israel statutes and judgments. You know, Ezra said, you know, Ezra told his heart, get ready, because we about to go to work. We gonna get in the word of the Lord until we are prolific in teaching this thing. We gonna get into the word of the Lord until it just flows out of us. It says he prepared his heart to seek the law of the Lord, the word of the Lord, and to do it and to teach it in Israel. Deuteronomy 32:45-47. And Moses made an end of speaking all these words to all Israel. And he said unto them, set your hearts unto all the words which I testify among you this day, which ye shall command your children to observe to do all the words of this law. For it is not a vain thing for you. He's telling the people, he said, set your heart, because the word of the Lord is the most important thing you can ever engage. He said, it's not a vain thing for you. It will bring you profit. He says, because it is your life, and through this thing, ye shall prolong your days in the land, whether you go over Jordan to possess it. God tells Moses to tell the people that there is profit in the word. You know why people don't pray? Because they don't see nothing. You know why people don't read? They don't know the profit in it. If you knew the profit in the word, you would engage that thing day and night and night and day. And Moses tells the people, engage your heart to seek the Lord. Engage your heart. Amen. It's not a vain thing for you. Amen. Tell your children to do it. Amen. Get your grandchildren in. Get your whole family in it. It is life.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
going around saying, get a life.
Yeah.
Well, the word is life.
Yeah.
You won't have to go get a life. You'll be walking in life, and life will be walking in you and talking in you, and you'll be glad that you set your heart to fill it with the word of God.
Yes.
Yes. He says, for it's not a vain thing. You know? And people say, you know, my mom, didn't want to go to church. You know, my mom come in there. I was sick every Sunday morning. Where is it at? It's in my belly. And my mom said, I guess you're going to church with a bad belly. But we getting up out of here. One day she came in with a pitcher of cold water. You know, I was faking again. Where is it at? I think it's my head. I woke up then. Well, this is what Moses said. He says, get your kids in.
Yeah.
Don't just you come. You may go as long as they under your roof, they come in too.
Yeah.
Get the whole family in it. It is not a vain thing. It is life.
Yeah.
And it will prolong your days.
Yeah.
And it will take you into the land that flows with milk and that most shit. The word will break the power of poverty, sickness, and disease, and all other kinds of soul diseases in the family. The word will expose the enemy and show you what you need to do. A specific word, not a general word, a specific. The word of God will let you know specifically where you belong.
Yes.
You know why most people don't want to go to work? Because they're not where they really belong. Same folk going out every Monday, like just like the world. Where you going to work? Where you think I'm going? Can't wait till 5 o'clock. It's not even 9 yet. Well, you know, that don't quit your job. And Pastor James ain't into that. Don't quit your job. Especially not nowadays.
Amen. Make it plain.
Remember back in the day, some of y'all remember back in the day, folk be inviting folk over to church. It's like half the church was going somewhere to eat over somebody. Not now. Church over, when you going home? When you going home? When you going home? Anybody invite you? No. Don't quit your job. Because somebody might not invite you over. Mm-hmm. You be having a Crippin' and a Pepsi all by yourself. I'm just saying. Don't quit your job. But fill your heart with the word so you can be led by the Spirit. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. And many times the more gifted you are, the more it's harder to find where you should be.
Yes.
I
have a friend of mine, they so gifted, they always asking me what are they doing. They're a teeter-totter with at least 20, 30 businesses. So did any of them work? No. And I tell them all the time, you got to hit the work. Yeah, I know. I've been telling you. You got to hit the work. But they can do just about anything. But it's not what you can just do. It's what you're called to do that brings you profit. I'm going to say that again. Thanks for asking. It's not what you can do. It's what you're called to do in the kingdom of God. What the anointing has called you to do. What the anointing is on you to do. What you've been commissioned by heaven to do. That's going to bring manifestation.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
So everybody got homework this week. Ask Lord, what am I supposed to be doing? When I'm that's from the pastor on that.
Yes.
What are we supposed to be doing?
Yes.
What are we supposed to be doing?
Yes.
What are you leading me into?
Yes.
You know, some people are sent and some people just went.
Yes.
And when you just went, you're not going to see the fruit of if you sent.
Yes.
I'm going to say that again. If you just go and do your own thing, you know. Amen. You're not going to see the fruit of being commissioned by God.
That's good.
So, let's close with this. I've said this before. I need to volunteers. I need two volunteers. Very important. Thank you. Good. Okay. My man. My ego, sir. Good to see you. Now, Brother Beckham, he's faith. Okay? And Clarence is confession. Okay? So now, Faith, you just say right there, me and Clarence are talking, he's confession. See, my point is, your faith is going to keep pace with your confession. You know, you hear a lot of people saying this. I'll never forget when I came into full gospel circles, some of my friends said, oh, you over at that church, name it, claim it, blab it, grab it. That's where you go in there? I said, you know, I was intimidated a little bit because I have been in that denomination all my life, you know what I mean? And, you know, but as things are revealed to you, sometimes you got to move to go with those of like precious faith. See, you gotta go where agreement is.
I know, that's right, Pastor.
You gotta go where the waters are fresh to you.
Yes.
That's good.
Yes.
Remember, God told the people, we've been going around this mountain too long. Now, God doesn't give you some fresh revelation. You gotta follow it. It's okay. Clarence is, he's confession, all right? So let's go this way, Clarence. You see right there, brother. See, now we just talking junk. We just talking junk. We fussing, we criticizing, and Faith is saying right there. Faith is saying right there, right? Now we need a breakthrough. So we start talking the word of God. Okay, let's go to the scripture. Okay. That's right. He knew it. That's right. We start talking about the word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. We're starting now, we're talking about healing is the children's bread. Nothing's too hard for God. Amen. If God said it, he'll do it. If he spoke it, he'll make it good. Now, come on, Faith. See, now we're talking the word of God. We're talking the word of God. Here comes faith, because your faith will keep pace with your confession. Now let's all go together. Now we're talking the word. Come in the midst. Now we're talking the word. Faith is in the midst of us. Now we're talking the word. Now we're going to turn the corner. Now we're going to go somewhere now. But we're talking the word, because faith is going to keep pace with your confession. See, some people don't believe that. And name it, claim it, blab it, grab it. Just tell them, it'll come to you because I'm praying for you. That's why Moses said, now turn to Psalms 91. Turn to Psalms 91, we're going to quit. Psalms 91, he said, I will say of the Lord.
Yes.
And Moses said, I'm going to say of the Lord. You're my refuge. You're my fortress. You're my God. In you I will trust. Sure, what did he say? Sure enough, without a doubt, you are going to deliver me from the snare of the fowler and the noisome pestilence. You're going to cover me with your feathers, and under your wings I will trust. Your truth is going to be my shield and my buckler, and I'm not going to be afraid, because I do not have a spirit of fear, but I have the spirit of power, I have the spirit of love, I have the spirit of a sound mind, and I can run through that truth, and I can scale that wall, because the more I say of the Lord, the more faith is going to come in the midst of what I'm saying, and make sure it will happen, because this is the victory that will overcome the whole world, even our faith. But you gotta talk, you gotta start talking the word.
Right.
You gotta start saying of the Lord. You can't say of yourself. When this gonna happen? Someone's prophesied over me 3 years ago. It's still in. It ain't gonna happen. You ain't talking about it. I don't know if we need to stone the prophet or not. No, you need to get your mouth in line. That's what you need to do. You need to ready to burn the incense, and an angel appeared to him. Right at the altar. His eyes got all big, and the angel said, "You're going to have a baby. You will live." And Zachariah started telling the angel all the reasons why they weren't going to have a baby. "We old. We've been there, done that. Nothing happened." And the angel got upset. The angel said, "What? I stand in the presence of God. And God told me to come here and tell you." And guess what, Brother Zach? You're not going to talk for 9 months. And he left Zachariah. He had to get a writing board. Just to say good morning. Good morning. How are you this morning? For 9 months he had to do that. And then it says, after John was born, they said, what you gonna name the child? Zach? John. He said, "Ain't nobody in your family named John. It's gonna be John." And it said, the string of his tongue was loosed, and he started praising God. Because death and life is in the power of the tongue. And your faith is released by your word. You want to know where your faith level is? Think about what you've been saying. Your words are your faith talking. So start saying what God has said. And your faith will begin to catch up to your words. And you'll begin to see things provided for you that you couldn't get outside of your faith. Your faith will take you past your education. Your faith will take you past all of the innate gifts and talents you have. God's going to use them. Don't get me wrong. God's going to use them. But your faith is going to take you to a place exceedingly abundantly above all you could ever ask, think, dream, or imagine. That's why the devil's always trying to get us off our faith. That's why he's always trying to get us off the word of God. But this week, know what you're going to do? You're going to put some new pictures right on your refrigerator. Put right on your refrigerator. Put them right on the refrigerator. And every time, and everybody in here look like they've been in the refrigerator. I don't see nobody. Yes. Including pastor. It look like it. We hit the refrigerator. We eat well as spirit life. But this week, every time you open that refrigerator, pop, smack that picture. Pop. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And then have a scripture. Have a scripture for it. Have your house on that refrigerator. And Father, I thank you. My desire, my heart is here. Glory to God. Put promotion on you. Every time you open that picture, I'm promoted. Glory to God. Because I'm the head and not the tail. Above only and not beneath. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. See, you got to say it, but you also got to see it on the inside. That's when it really begins to bubble over. When you say it with your mouth and your heart bear witness with it, the inward man can see it.
You teach a real good pastor.
And I'm a prophesy.
Yes, praise.
Spirit of God says some of you who weren't even expecting increase in this time of your life, you're comfortable, you've been blessed, but God said he's going to take you to another place.
Yes.
So get ready for a newfound journey in faith.
Amen.
Your eyes have not seen. Your ears have not heard what's in store for you in this season. Oh, you're blessed. Oh, you have enough. But God said he wants to take you to the land of more than enough. He wants this journey of faith. Amen. To be maximized with your time in the earth. God wants to know you some, he wants to show you some new things. Even though you've been surely blessed, there's a new day. You know, Joshua, that Joshua generation, they did a lot. They took over a lot of the promised land, but they never completed. They never took all of the promised land, because our God is an eternal God.
Yes.
And there's always more with him.
Yes.
But you're blessed. No need to stress. Amen.
Amen.
Walk in peace. Walk in your victory. God has given you. Amen.
Amen.
He has given you the victory. And remember, the victory is in what God has spoken. Romans 4:18, who against hope believed in hope, that he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken. When you speak the word, when you declare what God has said, your faith is going to come on the scene like never before, because your faith keeps pace with your confession. Somebody's going to have a new relationship with faith this week. Because you're going to change what you're saying.
Yeah.
And you're going to say what God says about every area of your life. And I had it in Genesis 1. It says, God created life in the midst of darkness. Since the earth was dark and void, darkness was on the face of the deep. Why? Because Lucifer was evicted and he became as dark as he was light. And the third of those angels, they became as dark as they were light. And within a short period of time, it was so dark and dirty in the earth, and God got tired of looking at it. And he said, let there be light. And light came on the scene. And then you'll see all throughout Genesis 1, verse 3, it says, and God said. Verse 6, and God said. Verse 9, and God said. Verse 11, and God said. Verse 14, and God said. Verse 20, and God said. Verse 24, and God said. Verse 29, and God said. But then in verse 31, it says, and God saw. He saw what he said. Now, if God had to speak it into existence, surely we need to speak some new things into existence.
Amen.
Amen. And be led to where we should be instead of just going. Be led, and the word will lead you, and it will guide you. And the seal of approval of his blessing will be on your life. Come on, let's give God some praise. Come on, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. He is worthy.